Hello everyone, my name is Edu and this is Ready Go Expat. In today's video, I'm going to show you three times that I appeared on Chinese media. You know, I lived in China for 5 years, and in this video, I want to show you three short videos where I was in the media, and it was actually very interesting, and there were some funny stories behind each video. Ready? Go! So in this first video, I was having dinner with a student. We used to have classes like in restaurants and stuff because it was mostly like conversation. So I was having dinner with her. She was one of the directors in the school. And all of a sudden, a Chinese woman who was sitting behind us started talking to her in Chinese. And she was asking about me, what I was doing there, if I was a teacher and everything else. And basically she said, I'm doing this project, I didn't understand what it was at the time, but she said, can he go there on Wednesday to take some pictures? And I was like, well, okay, I'll go. My student went with me and we went there to this place, and basically it was a clinic, a health clinic, and they were doing a commercial, an advertisement for the opening of the clinic. So they wanted me to pretend I was a doctor in the clinic. And it was really funny because I was not expecting any of that. But so I got there, you know, recorded with other Chinese doctors and nurses and everything. And then they invited me again, and then they asked me to bring two friends over. So I invited two friends to go there as well to pretend we were doctors in this clinic. And it was a really funny ad. It was a really interesting ad. The funny thing is that they showed this ad on like subway stations, on bus stops all over the city. So it was really funny because I had a lot of my students saying that they saw me like this morning, you know, going to school. They saw me on the way going to school and everything. So that was really funny. So this is the first ad I'm going to show you. It's a 30-second ad. I hope you like it.
美心健康体检中心坐落红谷滩，拥有温馨优美的环境，国际高端设备，联合国际国内影像专家团队及国内优质医疗资源，提供全方位专业健康管理及私人医生服务，提供精准个性化会员专属体检服务。美心体检，真爱你所有，钟爱你一生。预约热线 0799-8739-0111-8739-0111.
The second time I appeared on Chinese media, it was actually a local TV station. I don't know if it was TV or if it's just an online channel for the province of Jiangxi. So basically it was during the World Cup, okay? And in our city, Nanchang, there is this Brazilian bar that foreigners hang out there, Chinese locals hang out there as well. So the owner of the bar showed all of the Brazilian matches, actually a lot of the World Cup matches there. And then we went there, me, a Brazilian, and also other Brazilian friends went there to watch the match. And the TV went there and talked to us and filmed us watching the match. It was really funny. And they even asked me some questions and I replied in Chinese with the few words that I know in Chinese. It was really interesting. So here's the second video.
I always come here because we are Brazilian, so Brazil, Bashi, Dego, Fago.
Now, the third time I appeared on Chinese media, I was actually on Chinese national TV. I was on CCTV 1. Yes, it's a very interesting story as well. But just so if you don't know, CCTV 1 is like the biggest Chinese network. And they came to my city, my small city of Fuzhou, Linchuan. Fuzhou is in Jiangxi province, not the big Fuzhou down in the south of China. But this city was where the Chinese, they call him the Chinese Shakespeare, was born, okay, in the 1700s, I think. And his name is Tang Xianzu. So he wrote, you know, he's a playwright. So they call him like, and he was really popular, like Chinese opera, and he was really important for Chinese culture. So he was born in this small city of Fuzhou. So CCTV from Beijing came to China, to Fuzhou, to this small city, and they recorded in an opera place, very traditional, just like in the past. And they recorded there with some locals and also me as a foreigner. I was there and talked to them and answered a few questions about opera and the traditional Chinese opera. So it was a very interesting experience, and I learned a lot about Chinese, more about Chinese culture. So here's the time when I was on Chinese national TV. This is just a fun video, just to show like three times I was on Chinese media. It's just a fun video for you to see. I had a very good time doing it, and I hope you guys enjoyed it too. I'll see you next time.